Hey, what's up? This is Eric. Sometimes when I feel my computer is too slow and hear the noise from a crazy spinning fan, I need to open Activity Monitor on Mac or Task Manager on Windows to check what's going on there. If there is a process that is frozen while consuming a lot of CPU, you must be forcefully terminate it. This is usually one of the things we do often. Also from them, you can check the current CPU and memory usage, and you can also check the resource usage of each loaded process. This one I made does something similar. You can see my two ESP32 devices here. On the left, the WT32-SC01 is connected to my Raspberry Pi 02W, and on the right, the LilyPi is connected to my MacBook. There's a video comparing these devices, including these two, so if you need more information on these devices, check it out. You can see the connected system's CPU and memory usage, as well as a list of the top 5 processes that are using the most CPU. The middle widget displays the usage of resources, so you can see more intuitively. All graphics are represented in LVGL. It uses LVGL version 8 to draw the GUI. I like it a lot because it can make very nice screens even in the embedded environment. If you need a graphic environment, I strongly recommend using LVGL. It's really cool. What I'm missing? Oh, there's a battery indicator as well as showing the local time too. This is a very simple system monitor, but I think it can be very useful. Okay, let me show you how it works. The system is designed to be very simple. I had to write a separate Python script to get the specific information I wanted from the connected PC. It works on Mac, Windows, and Linux. Through this script, you can not only get system information, but also send data to the connected ESP32 via serial port. Perhaps writing is a more correct expression rather than sending because it's a serial communication. Also, this Python script should keep working because without it, you cannot get any information from your ESP32. Let me show you the JSON data from the Python script. First, this includes Unix timestamp and offsets for showing local time. This can indicate the time on your ESP32 screen. Get CPU and memory usage. You can bring the usage percentage for each CPU core separately, but I made it as simple as possible. Oh, I'm also getting info about battery here, showing how much battery is wrapped and is currently connected to the power. Finally, information on the top 5 processes with the highest CPU usage is included. On Mac, you need to set the permission to get this information. Now let's look at the ESP32 side. It displays all information via LVGL on ESP32. On ESP32, two texts work separately. One is a text that updates the screen while the LVGL handler works. The other one is a text that receives the data from the serial and sends it to the LVGL handler task, and passing data from task to task through a queue. This is a Beijing message passing method in FreeRTOS. Both the Python script and the ESP32 code can be downloaded from my project GitHub repository. To make the ESP32 code work on your end, you must first configure the display. I'm using LovyanGFX, so please set it for your display here. I believe you only need to modify the LCD panel you used and the connected GPIO pin numbers. For LVGL settings, I'm only using one type of font size here. I set the default font to Monster 16. That's it for LVGL. If you need anything about LVGL, please refer to my previous LVGL project videos. If the code for your ESP32 is ready, upload it after building. If there is no problem with the graphics driver, you can see the same screen as me. If not, please check the display settings again. It's waiting for the data from my Mac. Let's run the Python script. To run this script, you must install the requirement first. They are only PSUtil and Pi serial. Let me show you how to run it. You can check the necessary arguments by looking at the help. The last thing you need is to find out which serial port the device is connected to. This is the ESP32 serial port connected to my Mac. This may be different in your environment, so you should find it yourself. Now you can run it by adding your serial port. On Mac, you need to run it with sudo permission to get process information. As soon as data is received from my Mac, the loading screen disappears and starts to monitor the system. It works fine. It works seamlessly, but I'd like to add a few features more, like adding a couple of pages to show more detailed system information, and also allowing you to directly kill the process you want. If so, it's going to be a very good functional device. Let's see how it goes. Today's project ends here. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.